occasionally when we sing your hymn at work, occasionally we join in the wonderful choir, occasionally we celebrate as a congregation and as a conference. In our lives over the years. So we pray you to go before us now as we join in this act of worship, in this groundbreaking, in this dedication to your honor and your glory. And may your people be blessed especially. Amen. My sisters and brothers, this is a very special occasion indeed. I welcome you as you come to support and join in our celebration as we break ground for our future church home. It is significant that this comes as we today celebrate the 558th anniversary of the Moravian Church worldwide. And this year, celebrating 250 years of Moravian missionary activity in Barbados. It is a significant year for St. Philip Fellowship as well as it is 25 years of existence here. And so we will be inviting you to join us again to share in our anniversary celebration in July. Therefore, my friend, welcome to God be the glory as we gather together to break from at St. Philip. Join me then in our litany of praise. Let me say, however, that we have received greetings from the Reverend Evelina and the Reverend Dr. And they join in rejoicing over this event. And coming from our province, the chairman of peace in Christ, I greet you in the name of Jesus Christ, our chief elder. The Eastern West Indies province are listening on the occasion of the groundbreaking exercise for the start of work to erect your sanctuary on this historic day in the life of the Moravian Church. It was on this day, March 1st, 1457, that the Moravian Church was born. The groundbreaking exercise suggests that you have found yourself and are making a statement that you have come of age. You are saying that you are ready to stand at the beam of righteousness and a watchtower in the community in spirit. As you celebrate and rejoice, it is good to take a glance into the past to see where you have come from, so that the mistakes of the past would not be repeated. It is good as you celebrate this milestone to begin construction for your sanctuary, that you never lose sight that everything begins with God, and so rejoice in the Lord. As you rejoice in the Lord, I encourage you to renew your faith daily. Once your faith is being renewed, you are building a foundation that will last. The PC was very strategic when it discerned that it was time for the St. Philip Fellowship to have its own pastor to grow and develop into a vibrant congregation. The St. Philip Fellowship is situated in the fastest growing area of Barbados. There are thousands of persons who live in this development. The church has a mandate and responsibility to reach out and minister and impact lives. This is part of the living out of the thematic focus of our provincial theme, Advance the Kingdom. One of the ways to advance the kingdom is through church planting. Church planting must result in church growth. St. Philip Fellowship must therefore ignite and reignite the flame in the other congregations. At this time when crime and violence is on the increase, the church must continue to be a beacon of hope to those who believe that they are under siege by the criminals. I challenge you to impact the community in such a forceful way that persons would claim this church as their own. Seek out the sick, the downtrodden, the youth, and those who seem to think that no one cares. Develop programs to empower and elevate our people, and make the church come alive and be a living organism in this community. If the church fails to reconnect with the community and minister to the needs of the people, it will become irrelevant. As you rejoice at this accomplishment, may I remind you that the church could have a magnificent building, the best furnishings, wonderful music, and all the modern electronic gadgets. No, Jesus, it is nothing. The church is about proclaiming the life-transforming message of Jesus Christ. Whatever the church does, it must point beyond what it is doing. It must point to Jesus and Him crucified. The Eastern Resting is promised to salute you on this milestone. Congratulations, and may God bless you more than you can ever imagine. Sincerely in Christ, Reverend Dr. Cartwright Jarvis, Chairman of the PEC. With these greetings then, let us join in our litany of praise. Lift up your heads, O gates, and be lifted up, O ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. Unless the Lord builds the house, those who build it labor in vain. And Jacob took the stone which he had under his head and poured oil upon it and called it Bethel, which means the house of God.
Thank you. But just moving around.
Thank you.
not only here in Barbados, but throughout the world, of mission work. We are celebrating 250 years since our arrival here in Barbados, and we are going to drop. I'm inviting you to join us. Just wave your hand, my dear sister. Just wave your hand. How are you? You're doing well? Praise the Lord. Just wave your hand. Come on. Wave your hand and dance with us. Come on. Just celebrate. We are celebrating this year, making 25 years since it's in Berlin. We use the Princess Margaret Secondary School where we meet for worship every Sunday at 8 a.m. For Sunday school at 9:30 here. And you can celebrate with us today at this day. Come on, everybody, celebrate. Inspire us.